Now that you cleaned up your CAD drawing, it's time you send it to 3ds Max. Before you do, notice the units of your CAD drawing. This one was drawn using the decimal system with the millimeter as a base unit. In 3ds Max, your default system unit is set to inches. So some scaling is needed between the metric system from AutoCAD and the default imperial system in 3ds Max. Of course, you can set your system unit in 3ds Max to match that of AutoCAD, but leave that alone for now. You'll do the appropriate scale conversion at import time. Your display units, however, can be set to your liking. In this tutorial, use the US standard setup with the foot as a base unit. To import the AutoCAD drawing, you can use either the import command or the file link command. The file link command has the advantage of keeping a live link to AutoCAD. If you make a change to the drawing in AutoCAD, you can update that change in 3ds Max. There is a separate tutorial on this subject named Using File Link. In this case, you'll simply use the import command. Locate and select the Condo 3D-DWG file you saved earlier. In the Geometry tab, enable the Rescale option and ensure the incoming file units are set to millimeters. As you recall, that was the base unit for the CAD drawing. In the Derive AutoCAD Primitives By list, choose the first option, Layer Blocks as Node Hierarchy. This option doesn't take into account AutoCAD materials. That's fine, as you'll be creating materials in 3ds Max. Leave all other options to their default values. In the Layers tab, enable Select from List. Choose only those layers you identified as 3D layers. That's all you'll need in this case. In certain situations, you may opt to keep other layers that may help you as reference. Click OK when done. All closed polylines you created on the 3D layers now appear in the scene. Select an exterior wall section. Notice that all entities on the same layer are recognized as a single object. This is the default conversion method between the two applications and actually works well in most situations. In this case, all exterior wall sections are recognized as one editable spline that you can now extrude to a height of 10 feet. This works nicely, but leaves a few gaps above the doors. Press F4 to see the underlying geometry. To create the door headers, you need a horizontal slice through the walls, positioned 7 feet high, which is a standard door height. With the outer wall selected, add a slice modifier. Expand the modifier and choose Slice Plane. Using the Move tool, set the slice plane at 7 feet high using the Transform Tie-Pins. You can see how this affects the structure of the wall. Right-click and convert the object to an editable poly. Using Polygon Mode, select two polygons facing each other above a door opening. Use the Bridge tool to create the header. Repeat the procedure to create the three other headers, but leave the openings where the curtain wall should be. Exit polygon mode when done. Extrude the interior walls by a value of 9 feet. Add the slicing plane set to 7 feet high as you did earlier. Convert the walls to an editable poly and create the headers above the door openings. In some cases, you may need a bit of a cleanup before you use the Bridge tool. Notice the extra vertical segments on this part of wall. They serve no purpose and should be removed. In Edge mode, select a vertical edge and then choose Loop to select the whole vertical line you wish to remove. Hold the Control key and then press the Backspace key to remove the edges. It is important to hold Control to delete any vertices associated with the removed edges. Repeat the procedure to remove any unwanted loops on the wall. Go back to Polygon mode and bridge the remaining gaps after that. The partition separating the kitchen area from the living room also needs a bottom bridge. Select all the polygons that make that partition and choose Slice Plane. Set the plane height to 3'6", 3.5 feet, and then click the Slice button. Exit Slice Plane mode when done. Select the appropriate polygons to bridge the lower part of the wall. For the fireplace opening, select the front face and use the Poly Inset command. You can then adjust the edges to create an opening of acceptable size, and then use the Poly Extrude command to punch in a hole. Finally, select the floor and give it a negative 1 foot extrusion. Do the same for the balcony. In very little time, what was a 2D CAD drawing only a moment ago is starting to take the full shape of a 3D environment. In the next movie, you'll get pointers at creating some basic materials for the walls and floors.